Good morning, and thanks, Andrea. We appreciate everybody joining the call today. We're very excited to introduce the new contract for classroom furniture and related products and services. We've got a great presentation today, and so I'd like to kick things off to this morning, afternoon, depending on where you're calling in from, with just some information about U.S. Communities for those of you that may not be fully aware of our program. U.S. Communities is a nonprofit purchasing cooperative, and we were founded over 20 years ago by a group of political subdivisions who wanted a better way to procure goods and services. And so as the program evolved and grew, it became a national organization, and that's really when the presence and credibility of the U.S. Communities began to take off. We're currently, our foundation board is made up of these five organizations, and I'm not going to read all of them for you, as many of you can read the screen on your own. But for those of you on the call today and this classroom, this contract is very K-12 centric, not only for K-12. For those of you that are school representatives on the call today, you may all fully be aware of the Association of School Business Officials International. For those of you that are not schools, there's a lot of great offerings as well for cities, counties, community colleges, et cetera. But those of you that are K-12, I think you'd understand who ASBO is just a little bit more. So that presence and credibility takes us to something that is very unique. We are the only purchasing cooperative in the country who was founded and is currently run in this fashion. In addition to that, we have over 90 state sponsors throughout the country. So depending on what state you hail from, there may be multiple sponsors in your state. And really that further credibility that we get through those sponsor relationships ensures that the processes and requirements that each one of the lead public agencies takes into consideration as they put a contract out, of which we'll have the pleasure of hearing from Tony Crosby today in just a few short minutes about that process. So in terms of the credibility, obviously, you know, we're very proud of our sponsor and national sponsor and state sponsor relationships. The true rubber meets the road with our advisory board. This group of public procurement professionals is really what differentiates U.S. Communities in the marketplace, and I think why many of you on the call today really find value in these contracts. These lead public agencies are your peers, your colleagues, whether they're from a school or not, and they put this process, they put these contracts through the same process or maybe even a greater process than you'd be required to follow in your state. So really at the end of the day, you're piggybacking off of or interlocally cooperating off of one of these lead public agency or advisory board representatives' contracts. Thus, why many of you are able to use these contracts there locally in your state. So again, as I mentioned, we will be hearing from Tony today. Tony represents Prince William County Schools. And they also practice what they preach. As you can see there, many of these agencies, while not mandated to use the program, like no agency is, they do use the program and have found extreme value in being a participating agency as well. So as we move over to the next slide, we always kind of get the why use U.S. Communities. And I'm not going to read through every one of these as well, but what I hear a lot in the field working with political subdivisions like yourselves is, number one, you know there's no cost to use the program, so it doesn't hurt to take a look. And if we can help you work smarter and not harder in certain instances where you have staff allocation issues, you're trying to get more done with less people, this is where we can really come in to help you out, in addition to the great purchasing power the program brings with it. And so when we look at the various reasons on why agencies, U.S. Communities, these are the big ones that stick out. But I think another aspect that many of you on the call may or may not be aware of, but I think it's really important to know that that lead public agency model is imperative as you're evaluating the contracts and looking at the information. So, you know, again, further validating the front end of what we already discussed, hearing from Tony today and knowing that it went through a process by a political subdivision that you can relate to and understand, it gives that level of credibility. And then again, we have our program managers out in the field. We have 14 full-time program managers. They're there to assist you and answer those questions on behalf of the lead public agency as well as anything specific to the U.S. Communities program and process. So as we move forward, I am not even going to try to do the justice that Tony will do, the process of being a lead public agency, but just to further reiterate how this process works. So you can see that each contract has a lead public agency. These RFPs or ITBs are issued by that lead public agency, advertised online and in the paper, and over 5 different locations. We also advertise in Canada through the Merx system. This contract was issued as an RFP. There is a national evaluation team of your peers, in addition to the lead public agency, who come together to read all the suppliers' responses, score those said responses in accordance with the evaluation criteria that was designed and developed for that RFP or ITB, and then they make recommendation for award alongside the lead public agency. At the end of the day, the lead public agency creates it, solicits it, awards it, and maintains it throughout. Many of you, that is a mandated process. So again, that lead public agency process is imperative for this contract to be of value on the front end for you there. As I mentioned, since it is held day-to-day, U.S. Communities works alongside the lead public agency in a variety of capacities, assisting with quarterly reviews as well as third-party audits. But at the end of the day, you are utilizing a political subdivisions contract to access the Verco offering as well as the Verco partner offerings. And so with that being said, it is without further ado that I have the pleasure of introducing Tony Crosby from Prince William County Public Schools. And so, Tony, I'm going to ask that you go ahead and go ahead and talk about the solicitation and selection process for the group here.
Thank you very much, Doug. Good morning to all, and well, I shouldn't say all, to some, and good afternoon to most. First of all, I'd like to just start off by saying it is truly an honor that Prince William County Public Schools was viewed and approached to be the lead agency for this solicitation. And it was not taken lightly that we were looked upon to lead this. So again, I'll stick to the script and be very precise. Again, we were the lead agency for this solicitation. It was when the solicitation was issued, we advertised this nationally as a $250,000 opportunity for the awardee. It's very distinguished, just a great evaluation team that we had, representatives from San Diego Unified School District, Beaverton Public Schools, Oregon, and Denver Public Schools, and Prince William County Schools served on the evaluation team. We issued this RFP on July 18th, and there were no addendums, and proposals were due on August 18th, 2017, which was the closing date. You will see that the scope was quite extensive, and the offering, which certainly our representatives from Verco will cover here after I'm done. These were the specific categories that were covered. I personally can relate to when this contract, I've been in the school business for quite some time, and as I look at the long listing of the opportunity to do a lot of one-stop shop when it comes to outfitting a school, I think attributes to the scope that was identified here. And so when you read through these lists of items that consisted of the scope, it really does fulfill the needs in outfitting a complete school. So again, I won't go through all those, and certainly I'm sure our Verco representatives will cover these in greater detail. But we did receive 6 responses to the proposal, which closed on August 18th. Of those 6, 5 were deemed responsive and responsible. We did have to reject one of the proposals for not being in compliance with the requirements. The next deck will show that the criteria for the basis of award were simply, we were assigned points to the proposer's ability and experience, to the scope of products and services proposed, their national supplier information, and pricing. These were the criteria that were used for the basis for award. Our school board here approved the award, or the award for this agreement in mid-October, and we awarded this to the highest rated offer, which was Verco. And the initial contract period is 5 years. So it's, if you try to get precise, it's 5 years and a month. We felt that it was important to award this immediately as a lot, because we're converting from the current contract. This really gives localities across the country the time to go ahead and put the new contract in place. And so when January 1st hits, you're ready and up and running. But this is a five-year contract with two-year periods for renewals. Very important. I certainly will take anyone's questions or inquiries via email, but all of these documents related to the RFP process and the contracts can be found on the U.S. Community's website. And that's kind of where we're primarily placing all the documents. We certainly will make them available here locally if anyone reaches out to us. And I will stay on the line for questions, if any. And again, the contract number is identified there. Don't let the TC fool you. I will be assigning this contract to someone locally here in our office, Karen Sopers, but I will stay very, very close to this contract for its duration. With that being said, I believe I now have the distinguished privilege of introducing Brian True with Verco.
Thanks, Tony. I appreciate that very much. Good morning and good afternoon to everybody. Thank you for taking your valuable time and jumping on this call. I'm Brian True. I am the Vice President of Sales for Verco's National Sales Group. Just a little bit of history. This is Verco's fourth contract through the U.S. Communities Cooperative Network. Our first contract was established back in 2003. One of the things that we're really proud of at Verco is we've sold, since 2003, we've sold over $1.1 billion of furniture and equipment through the program. This is a significant contract. It may be the most dynamic K-12 cooperative contract in the country. Actually, that's an understatement. It is the most dynamic cooperative purchasing contract in the country. One of the key elements of our success is that we're not only the largest manufacturer in the country, but we have two manufacturing facilities. We have one in our Torrance, California, corporate headquarter facility, and then we have a large facility in our Conway, Arkansas. So we're able to manufacture and distribute furniture at a very efficient level. The other thing that we've been very successful with, what's made the contract successful, is our direct sales model, which is unique in the furniture industry. So we have over 50 direct territory salespeople handling the lower 48, and then we have distribution through Alaska and Hawaii. Next slide, please. As Tony pointed out in his presentation, one of the strengths of this particular contract is all the key elements in a school building, elementary, middle, or high school, that have been identified. Literally, we've identified every element of a building outside of the athletic area. And these are just some of the highlights. Obviously, with the 21st century learning initiatives that are out there, STEAM and STEM are a hot commodity right now. A healthy movement, flexible furniture solutions, storage solutions, which really is getting the technology more than just storage of books and other things. And then a new category that Prince William has introduced is industrial and vocational solutions. And those of us that remember the days back when we had wood shops and automotive, that curriculum is coming back at the high school level across the country. Next slide, please. One of the key elements, and the next few slides are just demonstrations of what these modern learning solutions look like through the contract. These are what we call flex classroom solutions. This is not your grandfather or grandmother's classrooms anymore. Next slide, please. This is today's modern learning, or excuse me, modern library solutions. Next slide. These are your food court and open common areas solutions. Next slide, please. An illustration of what today's classrooms are beginning to look like or have looked like over the last few years. And I think the last slide. Another illustration of a flexible, collaborative learning environment. Next slide, please. Our contract does include a K-12 administrative office solution, which can be different than your corporate and higher ed office furniture. So these are some examples of some offices and schools or administrative buildings. Next slide. And then, as I mentioned earlier, STEAM, STEM, the sciences, at the bottom right-hand corner is a makerspace. This is new to the contract. And I think one more slide. Well, then the key advantages of the contract. This is obviously Verco's best offering. We've established this contract for so many years that it's become the go-to contract. Obviously, the pricing is based upon that $1.1 billion cooperative network. That's why we are able to give the best prices clear across the country. One of the new elements of our contract is we are now offering two levels of service with no minimums, which in the past contracts were not available. So going forward, Verco will be offering inside delivery and or installation with no minimums. And prior to that, there were a minimum, I believe it was $2,500 orders, a minimum $2,500 orders before any other additional services besides delivery was available. All of our prices, at least minimum, are net delivered to the customer. We have 18 named vendor partners. Most of those vendor partners have been with us since the inception of our first contract back in 2003. This is not a me-too contract. Verco is very particular about who we represent and who we work with. I think there are some competitors with other cooperative contracts that will, I guess, brag that they have over 250 or 200 or 150 suppliers that they can go to. And that is not what Prince William, Verco, or U.S. Communities is looking for. We're looking for very solid, very direct partners. The other thing that we've been able to do through the contract is we've developed a quick ship program, 72 hours for 200 SKUs on a truck. That is 12 months of the year. It can get a little dicey in July and August, but we do the best we can in those 2 months to try to keep those items in stock. On top of that, we have what we refer to as our Classroom Basics program. It's 3,000 SKUs. They'll ship in 2 to 3 weeks. Those are Verco's most popular colors and our most popular products. And a real key element of our success through the contract is our PlanScape project management program. And all the photos that you saw prior to this slide here were projects that we've done across the country through the PlanScape project management process. It's a free service. We have a PlanScape sales team. They work in conjunction with the local territory sales managers. We work with individual districts. We can go to the building level. We work with the district level, whatever the need of that school district is on their new building or new addition. We help with space planning. It goes all the way through installation, room by rooms, inventory. And it's been a program that we've had in place for 14 years, and it's very successful, and it would not be quite the program without the U.S. Communities contract. Next slide, please. Again, we want to thank Prince William. This is a huge undertaking, having had the fourth contract, and Prince William is the third advisory board or school district that's held a contract that we've been a part of. It is a big undertaking. It's a lot of responsibility, and we really appreciate Tony and his team for what they've been able to accomplish. And the last part says furniture solutions for all government agencies. And that, in fact, is true. Those of you that are not familiar with Verco, our key market, obviously, is K-12. However, we make hospitality furniture like folding tables and folding chairs. We've got a vast line of mobile convention center seating, as well as upholstered stack chairs. So, you know, we're trying to expand our market into the cities and the counties, as well as try to improve our presence at the higher learning area or level. And the last slide. And there's information on how to get started.
Thanks, Brian.
On Verco's, on Verco's website, we do have a find a sales representative, and it can be by state, if you know the counties, because we have some states have multiple reps. So even if you know the county, it'll drill down even deeper. Andrea, it's all yours.
Oh, awesome. Thanks, Brian, for presenting, and thanks to all of our presenters on the call today. At this time, if you have any questions, please type the questions into the chat panel. And just to reiterate, everyone who's on this call will receive a copy of the slides, and the recording will be available on the U.S. Communities website within the next week on our on-demand video page. So if you have any questions at this time, please type them into the chat panel. We'll give you a few moments to get your questions typed. And Brian, while we're waiting on some additional questions, this question is for Verco. Does Verco have any environmental programs or green solutions?
Well, yeah, actually, there are several things in Verco's stewardship program is what we call it. All of our furniture, all of Verco's furniture is GreenGuard certified. Probably, I think, one of the most reputable indoor air quality testing protocols in the country. So if you're doing a building and LEED points are important, Verco's contract and our product can help a district establish some level of LEED success. The other thing that we have that it's a program we've had for almost 12 years, we get one or two customers each year that will participate, and it's called our Take Back program. And what that does is we can come in and we can help do a needs assessment on current inventory. We can inventory product by classroom, by building. We can help grade it out and determine a product that maybe has outlived its usefulness, as well as establish a grading system for product that's been purchased over the last few years that is still good and should be maintained. And then in turn on that, we can have a program whereby the district have to put some skin in the game. We will take product back, not just Verco product, but all product. Things like metal can be recycled locally, and recycling metal can have a financial benefit, so the school districts can keep the steel. What we primarily bring back are wood components, soft plastic components, and hard plastic or compression mold components. We can bring those components back to our factories, recycle them, and put them back into new product.
All right. I'm not seeing any other additional questions that are coming in at the moment. On the screen now are all the presenters' email addresses, and you'll get this in the slide deck as well. If you can think of any questions that you may not can think of on the webinar, you can reach out to the presenters, and they'll be happy to answer your questions. Does any of the presenters have anything additional to add?
Yeah, hey, Andrea, Doug here. I have one that does come up a lot, and Brian, I don't know how much you want to elaborate on to it, but for those folks that are maybe not as astute with laying out and planning their potential projects, could you elaborate on what value-add services Verco offers in that arena through the planning and development budgetary phases for school districts?
Yeah, Doug. Well, it goes back to the PlanScape project management program that we have had since 2004. And every project means something different to each school district. It'll depend upon, you know, is it an addition? Is it a brand new school? And then, of course, is it a high school, middle school? Is it going to be a district managed project, or is it going to get down to the building level? Are we working with committees? But everything's all encompassing. It's from the space planning, determining what good, better, best solutions based upon the budget analysis that we do with the district. It's just every level up to and including the manufacturing, the loading, the shipping, the receiving, and the installation of the product. It's a full turnkey solution.
Great. Thanks, Brian.
I would just like to add one thing. I think Brian has really highlighted all the key benefits and advantages of what the program does offer and some of the things that have been added. One of the commitments, it has not been resolved yet or rolled out, but that's one of the things as we were going through the evaluation process is that Brian made a commitment that they would be looking into being able to track items or orders within the process versus it just shows up. So that's one of the things that, you know, we kind of had a commitment that, you know, that's something that they're going to be looking at building and developing. So I think that that's going to be a huge winner for localities across the country.
Yeah, Tony, thank you for bringing that up. That's a huge initiative for Verco for 2018. We're hoping to have some launch in the spring, but as those that have ever worked on anything that has to do with IT, right, there's delays, and but that is actually a huge initiative, and U.S. communities and U.S. community customers and our contracts are at the top level of that initiative so that we can get our customers through the program, have the ability to do all the things that you said, to place their orders, to track the orders, a one-stop solution after the order is entered, if you will.